doors and march through the halls of Congress, it appeared to me that the response outside was slow. Jeremy Kinger is a former chief of the U.S. Capitol Police, who estimated that half to three quarters of some of the 2,300 Capitol Hill police officers were prepared. He says the force may have underestimated the potential of this protest.
The cavalry should have been coming to get those people the hell off their steps and the platform, but that would have been very, very ugly and difficult to do if you didn't have superior force.
Social media video from Wednesday's event appears to show Trump supporters entering a security perimeter with little resistance from officers. In another post, people appear to be posing for selfies with toes and uniform. After the breach, 1,100 D.C. National Guard troops were deployed, and hundreds of federal law enforcement officers were sent in to assist. Compare that to June, when around 5,000 guardsmen and 1,600 active duty troops were brought to the D.C. area in advance of protests following the death of George Floyd.
If this were a group of young people who was organizing under the banner Black Lives Matter, we would have seen triple the number of officers.
Eric Johnson is the president of the NAACP.
It was irresponsible to put lawmakers in danger the way law enforcement agencies did today. But it's equitable when you compare what we've seen all summer, peaceful protests and a response that was not consistent.
Ayer says those who did break into the Capitol could now face felony charges.
There's some pretty clear pictures of people in hallways and hanging from the walls in the Senate chambers. Hey, where?